Hello, hello, hello y feliz sábado. Bienvenidos a Daily Flash Latino, primer fin de semana del mes de noviembre. Can you believe it? Que ya llegamos a noviembre.
I know, right? How was your Halloween weekend?
Fíjate, mi mes de octubre estuvo buenísimo. ¿Sí? Muchas actividades. Estuvo un poco shocking con la noticia de que falleció el artista Matthew Perry, pero...
That was big.
Yeah, yeah, that
I'm
was...
I'm a big Ferenc fan, to be
really?
Honest with you. Yeah,
I would never expect for you to say that.
Sí, no, I watched the seasons like 5 times, I think. I repeated
¿En serio?
It. Yeah, I love it. Matthew Dios Perry, mio. We really lost a good one. I really...
We was, really did.
It was sad. But what did you dress up as?
A lot of things. I dressed up as a mom, as a no-no. I did Peach and I did Barbie. Did you dress up as anything?
I dressed up as a motorcycle, a biker, right?
And okay.
Then the other one was a vampire.
A vampire?
Something I invented.
Ay, that's awesome. You got the look. Okay, pues vamos entonces a entrar a todo lo que tiene que ver con farándula, what's trending. El ex modelo a la candidatura para la presidencia mexicana, Eduardo Verasteguí, anunció su renuncia e invitó a la ciudadanía a renunciar a los 7 partidos, que son como las 7 plagas que están llevando a México a la ruina. Take a look.
Voy a renunciar a la presión de quienes no quieren que participe en esta campaña de recolección de firmas porque quieren seguir con los mismos de siempre. Voy a renunciar a los mismos de siempre porque creo en el cambio y creo en un México renovado. Mi renuncia no es para darle gusto a quienes dudan, a quienes critican, a quienes señalan, no. Mi renuncia es para edificar el México que todos queremos y por eso también quiero invitarlos a ustedes a hacer un compromiso de renuncia. Los invito a renunciar a los 7 partidos políticos que son como las 7 plagas que están llevando a México a la ruina.
Wow. El aspirante a ser candidato presidencial independiente expresó imágenes de políticas y políticos que participarán en las elecciones del 2024, a quienes califica como los mismos de siempre. Y la verdad que yo veo a Eduardo Verasteguí, me entraron muchos pensamientos cuando vi estas imágenes, porque dije, contra, maybe él quiere hacer algo estilo Donald Trump, que fue...
Eso iba a decir,
fue,
yes.
Sí, que está en entretenimiento, sí. Es un algo controversial.
He's an actor, right?
Yeah, él es actor, él fue okay. Modelo y todo eso, so maybe he's trying to, like, use that angle to become sí. Popular.
Para mí, you know, I was gonna say, para mí eso de lo de Twitter y todas las redes sociales, do you think it's gonna become something that we're gonna be looking forward for our presidents, maybe?
What do you mean? Que sean como controversiales que, en redes sociales.
Que tengan un following, posiblemente. Que sean...
Yo creo que es importante.
¿Verdad?
Yo creo que
it's,
es importante...
It's kind of like the new generation coming
yeah.
In, right?
Y I feel like que ser controversial como que se ha convertido parte de todo esto. Pero yo a veces... Yo recuerdo a Eduardo Verasteguí del video de Jennifer Lopez, Ain't It Funny. So, yo veo a este hombre que es super sexy y ahora lo veo como con tanta rabia y coraje. And he's probably just mad about everything that's going on in politics or whatever. Pero
ya veo porque te gusta, yes.
No, me gusta, no, wow. Me gustaba, pero ya no. No
oye, pero por, posiblemente, no es que, posiblemente que no es que se renuncie. Están diciendo que posiblemente va a tirar otra, like another take after this.
Maybe
saying that él está dejando de lo viejo. Lo que me estoy renunciando desde lo viejo, pero voy para encima con esto. Pero le faltan las firmas, llegado como a 37,000, se supone que llega como
a 40,000. I think it has to do with money, honey. To run to be a, like a president, you need some money and you need backup.
That's
and then he just didn't
yes.
Have it.
That's why I need you.
No, not me.
Oye, yes, chequéate esto. La espera Dímelo. Terminó. Adamari López está muy contenta por el actual rumbo de su carrera en la pantalla chica. Ella volvió, baby. Tras varios meses de rumores, la actriz y presentadora puertorriqueña confirma que se une a la fila de Televisa Univisión con un nuevo proyecto que pronto saldrá al aire en Estados Unidos y México. Un triunfal regreso a la casa pues en Televisa, en donde años atrás, como lo acordamos, despegó su carrera, convirtiéndose ahora en una de las favoritas del público. Y pues nosotros los fanáticos, ahora esperamos conocer mucho más de este show, me imagino, ¿verdad? Con Adamari, que estará de regreso en la pantalla chica. Y mientras llega el día, las felicitaciones y buenos deseos en esta nueva etapa laboral no se han hecho esperar entre sus publicaciones en las redes sociales, podemos decir, ¿verdad?
No.
La gente la está, they're filling her up with love, all over.
Tenemos hambre de Adamari López. Y oye, qué bendición ella conseguir un trabajo a solo 6 meses de irse de Telemundo, porque ajá. En este negocio está súper difícil tú conseguir un trabajo.
Correcto.
A mí es la realidad, no hay muchas plazas abiertas, así que felicitamos a Damar y te apoyamos 100%.
Claro que
bueno,
sí.
Guys, ya mismito regresamos con mucho más en este sábado de Daily Flash Latino. Primer sábado de noviembre. It's Coquito
It's
Season.
It's November, baby.
It's Coquito Season.
Let's go.
Yes. Y las últimas semanas han sido un tanto difíciles en las noticias y por eso hoy en Todo Trending con Jess les quiero traer un par de noticias positivas. Let's bring the positive vibes. Meet NYC's most popular rat. Así vamos a comenzar con el que le llaman Donut Rat. And he's viral, sí, la ratadona. You see, when TikTok user Small Red Car, a.k.a. Carly Hittner, uploaded this video and captioned it with, Donut Rat treats his woman better than half of other rats in this city, she didn't imagine it would receive almost 3 million views. And as you can see, the rat steals the donut and then moves on to share it with that, what we are assuming is the rat's baby, bae, or bestie, or boo, or whatever it is, but they're cool, right? En este video me imagino que te recuerda the 2015 viral video of a rat carrying a large pizza slice down the stairs. We all remember that, it was viral. Well, amongst comments, people said things like, oh, he a provider, and a high value man. So fellas, take notes, okay? Now onto something else that, you know, we really love. I really love this song. It's for my little boo things. You've seen the viral TikTok dance during the past few months of Paul Russell's catchy tune, Little Boo Thing, right? It's a feel-good song and something the world could use right now, but it was first uploaded this past June with a sample of Best of My Love by The Emotions. Little Boo Thing became a viral sensation. Everybody was dancing it. I'm still trying to learn it. But so what's the backstory? What is up with this song? Was this even a full song? It wasn't, but hear from Russell himself.
It wasn't even a snippet of a broader song. It was like, that's all that I had. It wasn't, I didn't think I would make a full song. I just thought, like, fun content, you know?
Fun content, you know? How casual of him. Well, it has become more than that for him because the song is currently being used on shows like The Bachelor and in stadiums before major games. FYI, Russell quit his job the day the official full song was released, and you can't blame him. I mean, it's such a fun song. I have to control myself from not putting it on every single story that I have on Instagram. All right, moving forward in más noticias positivas que están trending, this one right here will give you all the feels. Amazon driver Elijah Bryant did much more than deliver a package at one Chi-Town home. Recently, he delivered some fashion pointers and scents. The 42-year-old was doing his typical route when he saw teen Luke Breyer trying to wear his tie well, properly as his fam waited around. Well, it looks like Bryant, he wasn't too happy with how long the tie was and had to do his thing and help the teen. I want you to check out this heartwarming moment.
My God, what's the name of that cologne?
Burberry.
Burberry. Oh,
it's a Gucci Guilty. It's
Gucci Guilty.
Ooh. Yeah, see?
Track car.
Track car. Get out of here.
Ooh-wee, we love it. Brian is a father of 3 sons and 5 girls. He said he felt the need to pass along knowledge he had learned as a teen himself, an avid churchgoer himself since he was a young age. He often dressed up nice in suits and attended with his family. But this story has more to it because in a recent interview, the teen's mom said the timing of this couldn't have been better. She said, we live here in Chicago where racial tension is so high, especially in our neighborhood. It was just great to see 2 people reacting to each other regardless of color. And that's the part that just really makes me happy. So you gotta love a story like this. I mean, my Amazon driver would never do that. I'm loving that. All right, guys. So I hope you're wearing waterproof mascara because the stories keep coming. And now I'm telling you about a single mom. I know, I'm kind of biased to all this. A single mom of 6 children is thanking some automotive tech students at a high school in Virginia who worked all year to fix up a car to surprise her and take a load off her back. The students gave the car to Michelle Mendez, who says, this is gonna give her the ability to take her kids to places they need to get to and from work. Giving Words, created by Eddie Brown and his wife, helps make a difference for single mothers. Brown said, the component that I look at is just hope. And just seeing that in her eyes as she received this car and just the excitement and it means for the boys. Well, guys, I hope your heart is full of lots of love and positive vibes with all of those stories. And we'll try to bring some more of those, that fun energy throughout the week. This is Daily Flash Latino.
And now, un mensaje importante que puede salvar vidas. Here's more.
Cuando se trata de salvar una vida, no te paralices. Saber RCP te puede llevar de espectador a salvavidas. Únete hoy mismo a la Nación de Salvavidas, aprendiendo RCP en heart.org/nation.
Okay, miren esto. A man claims that a territorial bird has singled him out after attacking him day after day on his route home from work.
No.
Alejandro Rios, de 25 años, bikes home from his kitchen catering job every day. Rios said he was first pecked on the head by a dive-bombing magpie bird, and he thought it was an odd occurrence. Rios had said that he soon realized he had become the bird's target after he was attacked multiple times on his same route home. The kitchen worker, who was wearing a helmet in the video that captured the attack, said he makes sure that the bird doesn't hit his eyes. Rios also had zip ties to his helmet to ensure the bird won't hurt his head in any capacity. Magpies are believed to remember faces, something Rios said that he recalled when realizing what type of bird he was going after him. I mean, what a story, right?
Well, it happened to my brother and my niece, something similar. So my brother, we're from, nosotros somos del área de New Jersey, and if you've met a man from New Jersey, yeah, super tough, well, I ain't scared of nothing. Boy, was he scared of this bird that kept attacking him and my niece anytime they left the house in the morning. I had never seen an Eagles fan, so afraid of a bird attacking him to the point where my brother wanted to move. Like, this bird kept attacking him. And I think it's true. They do recognize your face, and once they go on attack mode and they don't like you, it's over.
You know, they do say that birds are God's eyes, right? They watch everything.
I don't know about this one being godly, because
maybe my guy Rios has been doing some bad stuff. You know, this could be bad karma.
Yeah,
in my head.
Could be. Keeps but coming it is right scary. Back I don't want to get on a bird's bad side. Let me just say that. Okay, cambiando, switching gears. Muchos están haciendo la pregunta: ¿Quién es el niño influencer conocido como La Veneno? Luis David González La Veneno es un niño de 14 años que se volvió viral en redes sociales por su peculiar forma de vender dulces en la calle, pero también por su extravagante forma de vestir. David fue apodado como La Veneno. La fama de La Veneno lo ha llevado a compartir escenario con las influencers más populares del momento. Se volvió viral por primera vez en redes sociales tras ser grabado por un usuario, y se puede ver a La Veneno ofreciendo cajeta, un dulce típico de San Juan de los Lagos, Jalisco, de donde es originario. Fue precisamente donde La Veneno responde en doble sentido a las preguntas de la TikToker y finaliza con su peculiar frase, ¡y soporten! Dejando sorprendido a millones. Oye, uno nunca, cuando vemos este tipo de videos virales, uno nunca sabe cuál es el que se va a convertir en eso, porque casi siempre pasa, it happens by chance,
yeah,
right?
Literally.
You'd never think a kid selling candy being like, you know, sassy,
he's sassy, yeah,
was going to go viral, because we've seen those, but you just never know with those algorithms who's gonna be famous. So
yeah, I wonder where he gets it from, though. I mean, that
es there's gotta estilo. Be someone in his life
eso
who is sassy.
¿Sabe cómo se llama? Eso es estilazo.
Estilazo.
Okay?
Hashtag estilazo.
Hashtag estilazo. Hashtag estilazo. Oye, check this out. Hablando de TikTok, en TikTok circula un video donde aparece un joven desfilando en un evento escolar. Sin embargo, lo que más llamó la atención fue que el padre del adolescente no se despegó ni por un segundo de su lado. El clip está generando opiniones divididas acerca del compartimiento del señor, ¿okay? A quien tacharon de acosador. En dicho video aparece un grupo de jóvenes bastoneras que se encuentran realizando su coreografía frente a decenas de personas. Sin embargo, al lado de una de ellas se encuentra un hombre de media edad que permanece junto al adolescente por varios segundos e incluso la imite mientras baila, ¿ok? ¿Qué piensa de este hombre? ¿Esto es tóxico o qué? What's going on here?
It's just a dad. Es un papá de una niña bonita, y maybe él se siente que la tiene que proteger de alguna manera.
Y la está cuidando, ¿eh?
Bueno, tú no, es que no sabemos, no tenemos suficiente del backstory.
Exacto.
Pero en una sociedad donde a veces vemos que los padres son ausentes, por lo menos este está protegido.
Oye, sí, ¿verdad? Pero fíjate, I mean, would you like it if your dad was standing right next to you like that?
I wouldn't care, because I'm not doing anything bad, and I'm really close to my parents.
Aww.
So, you know, my mom is like a momager. I mean, she would be, she was always next to me whenever I did stuff when her health was better. I'm surprised que no tiene una cámara o algo así, at least to like videotape everything. It does look, pero será que él es policía o algo así? I wonder if he's like in law enforcement.
Yeah, he's got to be like,
because he's got like that stance of law enforcement.
Yeah, he's kind of like a detective, kind of standing right next to you.
Yeah, and a cop dad, that's how they act.
Yeah, I think if you hit on the girl, You'll just see him right behind her. He just comes
up. No. All 911 will be there. Okay, well, speaking of girls and things like that, the pressure is on when naming a royal baby. And Fernando Fitz James Stewart of Spain gave his new little girl several. The 17th Duke of Huescar and his wife, Sofia Palazuelo, face a dilemma following the recent baptism of their second daughter. Fernando and Sofia celebrated the christening of their daughter. And just get ready for this. Her name is, oh my God, I need some water. Sofia Fernanda Dolores Cayetana Teresa Ángela de la Cruz Micaela del Santísimo Sacramento del Perpetuo Socorro de la Santísima Trinidad y de Todos los Santos. Woo! They better pay me extra for reading all that. The baby was named in tribute to Fernando's late grandmother, the Duchess of Alba, who had 19 names. Now, the aristocrat died in 2014 as the most titled person in the world, en el mundo, through heritage and marriage with a whopping total of 57 titles. Despite the inclusive intentions, the baby's name, by law, listen to this, cannot be accepted by civil registry as a national record and capped at a shorter... See, how do they expect a gift certificate to carry all those names? A username? What is it? It's impossible.
A username?
I can barely get Jessica in with seven letters.
A username, like, Barcelona.
Let's say username. Well, nobody's going to have it, I'll tell you that much. But, right? Like, I think
I feel like... Even you know what's crazier? The language barrier. With the names coming de Puerto Rico. O sea, tú llegas de Puerto Rico para los Estados Unidos y tu nombre tienes cuatro partes en tu nombre y tu maestra tratando de decir, is he present here? You know, is Hector Fabian Marcano Hernandez here? And I'm like, whoa. Like, they call you by every single name you have
here. Well, because law, I mean, legally, they probably feel like they have to just in case. I mean, I don't know, pero yo siempre, I just go by... Jessica Reyes, my other last name is Jessica Reyes Rodriguez. So just J-R-R has always been like...
J-R-R, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, I know. It sounds similar to a radio station you work near. But yeah, I've never been a fan of like really long names, but my son's name is Sebastian Enrique, and those are long names. So.
Pero se lo dejaste Sebastian Enrique ya?
No, no, tiene su apellido that I'm not going to say on air, but yeah.
Ah, bueno, yeah, vamos a claro que sí. Whoa, come on, guys.
Guys, well, we'll be back with more fun, more Saturday vibes. First Saturday of November. I keep saying it because I'm in shock.
I'm lit.
I cannot believe. Welcome back to Daily Flash Latino. Y cuando un agente del FBI contesta una línea telefónica de emergencia en la Casa Blanca, su vida se sumerge en un mundo de conspiraciones, peligros mortales y espionaje. This is today's Netflix must-watch series, El Agente Nocturno.
The FBI is the United States' premier law enforcement agency.
Ma'am, please take my seat.
We have a zero-fail mission to uphold, which means that we expect nothing short of perfection.
FBI, I need everybody to exit the train right now.
Now please stand as I administer your oath.
Welcome to the White House, Peter. Have you ever heard of Night Action? It's a top secret investigative program within the FBI.
So you want me to be a night agent?
God, no. I want you to answer the phone for them. It rarely rings.
Yes, go ahead.
I'm in danger. There's intruders. What do I do?
It's gonna be all right. I'm on my way.
We just lost two federal agents. They suspect someone in the White House of being involved.
They're after me now, aren't they?
Go! I have orders to protect you with my life.
The more you know, the more dangerous this becomes. You have no idea what you're getting into.
You found something.
This isn't a terrorist attack. This is an assassination attempt.
How do we know that you aren't in on this?
You're really on my side, aren't you?
Come on!
I haven't told you everything yet.
This plan of yours? Or wrong about any of it. We're done.
Take the wheel!
Oh my my goodness. Wow. Me tenía como que, oh my God.
I'm such
si
a fan.
Si tuviese popcorn. Okay.
I'm such a fan of action movies.
You
a mí me encantan las explosiones, los disparos, los carros rápidos, las motoras. I love it all. Oh my God. I wish I was in one of those movies. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, no, you're trying to scare me. No sé. Bueno, mi amor. Con eso nos despedimos por hoy. Be sure to follow us on social media to keep up with the latest news, entertainment, and news.
Okay. Nos veremos pronto aquí mismo at the same time. Chao.